Greetings to you. As always, I sincerely thank you for joining me for my weekly messages. Will you take your Bible and turn to the Gospel of Mark, chapter 2, verses 15 through 17. Now it happened as he was dining in Levi's house that many tax collectors and sinners also sat together with Jesus and his disciples, for there were many and they followed him. And when the scribes and Pharisees saw him eating with the tax collectors and sinners, they said to his disciples, "How is it that he eats and drinks with tax collectors and sinners?" When Jesus heard it, he said to them, "Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick. I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners unto repentance." My message is titled, Love in Action. I'd like to ask you a question. I'd like you to be honest with yourself. You don't have to reveal the answer to me or anyone else for that fact, because God knows the answer. So here's the question. Who is that person that you are uncomfortable being around, or you'd rather not be around at all? Maybe the person gets under your skin, rubs you the wrong way. Maybe you're overly concerned about what others think about you being around the person. As we live life, we're going to run into folks who don't look like us, don't act like us, don't think like us. Should we write them off? Should we avoid them altogether? Or should we view them through the eyes of Jesus? In the text, Jesus is dining in the home of Levi, a former tax collector who had been recently called to follow Jesus. Here Jesus is dining in the home among many tax collectors and sinners, and it caused quite a stir. You can imagine the whispers, turned head, raised eyebrows. You can imagine the thoughts that were running through the minds of the religious leaders. You see, in Jesus' day, tax collectors were despised. They were perceived to be greedy and thieves. And the religious leaders were just taken off their feet. They were thinking something is wrong with this picture. In fact, they said to Jesus' disciples, "How is it that he can eat and drink with tax collectors and sinners?" Jesus, in that moment, demonstrated what it means to love folks and what it means to really care about people. He didn't allow their raised eyebrows, their judgmental and disgusted looks to stop him from sharing a meal with Levi and, in the eyes of the onlookers, the undesirable guests of Levi. He didn't allow their judgmental thoughts to stop him. He demonstrated love in action. You see, Jesus' mission was always before him. The Bible says he came from heaven to earth to seek and to save that which was lost. When Jesus had a conversation with Nicodemus at night, he was on a mission. When he called Zacchaeus out of a sycamore tree, Jesus was on a mission. When he met the adulterous woman at the well, Jesus was on a mission. When he stopped by the leper's colony to demonstrate compassion and care, Jesus was on a mission. Jesus was in Levi's house because he had been invited there, obviously. But he was also there because he was motivated by his love for people. You see, Jesus's love for people was more important to him than what people thought about him. He demonstrated love for the tax collectors and the sinners. He wanted them to come to a saving knowledge of himself. For that reason, he said to the religious leaders, "I didn't come to call the righteous, but I came to call sinners to repentance." Should we write folks off who don't look like us? Should we avoid people who don't act like us or think like us? I think we can answer that question by asking another question that's all too familiar to us. What would Jesus do? And in the text, Jesus demonstrated what he would do and what we should do. You see, the love of Christ forgives others. Levi wasn't always a Christian, but Jesus saved him and ended up sharing a meal in his home. The love of Jesus forgives others. Not only does the love of Christ forgive others, but the love of Christ fellowships with others. Can you imagine how the tax collectors and sinners felt sitting next to Jesus? dining at the same table with Jesus, they were valued. They were validated. They felt important. They felt honored. They felt recognized. The love of Christ fellowships with others. And the love of Christ focuses on others. Jesus' intention was to meet the tax collectors and sinners there and to inevitably win them to the Lord. You know, we miss many opportunities when we don't love like Jesus. We miss many opportunities when we don't demonstrate care, concern, and compassion for others. We miss vital opportunities to share the gospel of Jesus. We miss prime opportunities to turn people's hearts and attention toward God. When we love like Jesus, we will change hearts. Change hearts, change marriages, change homes, change communities, and we'll eventually change the whole world for Christ. May God help us all to love like Jesus and to put our love in action. May the Lord bless you and keep you in his care until this time next week.